playing and having fun. We're the Nirks.
Lurking way out beyond the Kuiper Cliff. I'm an extreme trans-Neptunian object that could have easily been missed. They found me accidentally while hunting for Planet 9. I'm under the gravitational influence of a much larger object, not mine. Could Planet 9 be hiding somewhere very near? Astronomers certainly hope that my discovery will make that clear. Is Planet 9 here? I'm the Goblin. I take about 40,000 years to complete one orbit around the sun. The closest I come to the sun is 65 AUs. That's my perihelion. One AU, or astronomical unit, equals the distance from Earth to the sun. So I'm 65 times further from the sun than your planet at my perihelion. I get even further away when I'm at aphelion. Around 2,300 AUs, or in miles, over 213 billion. That's really far! Objects whose perihelion is beyond the Kuiper Cliff. Trans-Neptunian objects known as Sednoids, of which I was the third discovered after Sedna in 2012 VP-113, but of the three of us, I have the orbit that is most extreme. My orbit cuts inside both of theirs as I get closest to the sun, but then I retreat way out beyond either of their aphelion. Here I go! Shepard, Chad, Drew, Hio, and David Tholen found me in October 2015. My discovery was unexpected and very close to Halloween. This and the fact that TG387 was my provisional name gave them the idea for my nickname, and the Goblin is who I became. My official name is Lelea Kuholua, a Hawaiian name comparing my orbit to a bird that migrates from Hawaii to Alaska, the Pacific Golden Plover. There we go. Extremely small in size, about 8 times smaller than Pluto. That's pretty small for an object that has so much further to go. Astronomers don't know much about my appearance because I'm so dim and far away. So for now, I'm a dwarf planet candidate, and that's what I will stay. I'll continue my creeping and sneaking around the outer solar system and live up to my notorious nickname, the Goblin.
Quaoar with my tiny moonway what? A special dwarf planet because two rings are what I've got. Named after the Tongva tribes, god of creation. A Native American tribe from the Los Angeles basin. Discovered by Mike Brown and Chad Trujillo in 2002. From the Palomar Observatory, where making discoveries is what they do. My moonway what is named after the Tongva god of the sky. Waywat is the son of the god Quaoar. That's why. The Kuiper Belt is where you will find me. Out beyond Neptune, where it's cold and icy. I take around 286 years to orbit our sun, but only about 18 hours to complete one rotation. I have almost a perfect circular orbit around the sun, which is quite different from my other dwarf planet candidate companions. Sedna, the Goblin, and even Pluto have much more elliptical orbits. That's the way they roll. I am candidate Quaoar with my tiny moonway what? A special dwarf planet because two rings are what I've got. I'm approximately 43 AUs from the sun you see, so it takes about 5 hours for sun's light to reach me. A QB-10 is what they call me. A Kuiper Belt object not moved by Neptune's gravity. I'm far enough from Neptune that my orbit's all my own. I have my own orbital path through space that I like to roam. I have two very special rings around me. Both are much further away from me than they should be. This has confused a lot of scientists, because two rings that far out shouldn't exist. No one would have noticed my rings at all if it hadn't been for stellar occultations. That's what it's called. Kind of like an eclipse when I pass between Earth and a distant star. Astronomers see my silhouette, including where my rings and moon are. I am getting Quaoar with my tiny moonway what? A special dwarf planet because two rings are what I've got. Named after the Tongva tribe's god of creation. A Native American tribe from the Los Angeles basin. Like my friends, the other dwarf planet candidates, my temperatures are as low as all the others get. So you better dress warm when you come to meet me, because my temperatures are so cold that you could freeze. I probably have volcanoes that spew water that turns to ice. These are called cold volcanoes, or cryovolcanoes to be precise. My surface has ice patterns that look like melted ice that has refrozen, leading scientists to believe that I have cryovolcanism. I am candidate Quaoar with my tiny moonway what? A special dwarf planet because two rings are what I've got. I'm very far away and extremely
in an area not known well. Beyond the Kuiper Belt is where I dwell. In the Oort cloud, a spherical shell that surrounds our solar system like an ice-filled bubble.
I'm Sedna, a dwarf planet candidate, hoping for a promotion. Named after the Inuit, goddess of the ocean.
November 2003, Chad Trujillo, David Rabinowitz, and Mike Brown were watching the skies from the Palomar Observatory, and that's when I was found. At the time, I was the furthest object discovered far away where it's cold and icy. So I was named after the Inuit, goddess of the sea. Legend says she lives in the coldest, darkest depths of the sea, where there is not light or heat, but plenty of space to roam free. Just like her, I'm drifting along in the cold, dark depths of space. Living in the chilling shadows is something I've come to embrace.
I'm Sedna, a dwarf planet candidate, hoping for a promotion. Named after the Inuit, goddess of the ocean. 84 billion miles from the sun, I travel on my own. I have no moons to keep me company, I'm all alone. I take over 11,000 years to orbit once around our sun. I can't even remember my last birthday celebration. My rotational period is fairly short, though. Approximately 10 hours for one Sedna day, you know. I'm so far away from the sun that if you were on the surface of me, an extremely bright star in the sky is all that you would see. I'm Sedna, a dwarf planet candidate, hoping for a promotion. Named after the Inuit, goddess of the ocean.
Even at perihelion, the closest I'll get to the sun, I'll still be beyond the Kuiper cliff when my orbit is done. In 2076, I'll be closest to the sun. 76 AUs is my perihelion. But I will get as far as 937 AUs when at aphelion. Other objects beyond the Kuiper cliff with elliptical orbits like me include the Goblin Orlelea Kuhonua and VP-113. We are known as Sednoids, which was named after me. Trans-Neptunian objects whose perihelion is still beyond the Kuiper cliff, you see.
I'm Sedna, a dwarf planet candidate, hoping for a promotion. Named after the Inuit, goddess of the ocean.
One of the reddest objects found in the solar system so far. Similar to the bright reddish color found on the planet Mars. My surface is covered in frozen nitrogen and methane. But astronomers also discovered water ice in my domain. It is extremely cold on me. Temperatures as low as negative 410 degrees. You will need to dress really warm to visit, or you will freeze.
I'm Sedna, a dwarf planet candidate, hoping for a promotion. Named after the Inuit, goddess of the ocean.
Chances of astronomers finding me were very low, you see. But sometimes when you are gazing at the stars, you can get lucky. No one can take my picture because very little sunlight reaches me. It's so dark that I'm hidden in shadow and still quite a mystery. It'll probably be a very long time until your scientists will learn more of my history. But maybe in the distant future, you'll be able to visit me.
I'm Sedna, a dwarf planet candidate, hoping for a promotion. Named after the Inuit, goddess of the ocean.
In the darkness far away, you'll find me as I make my way. Drifting beyond the eight planets in my own eccentric inclined orbit. The Kuiper Belt is where I dwell. A mirror of one you know very well. I know.
known as the Anti-Pluto. You can call me Orcus, though. Pluto and I may share some characteristics, but in many ways we are opposites. Across the solar system from each other, in mirrored inclined elliptical orbits from one another, mimicking each other from opposite sides of the sun. When Pluto's at perihelion, I'm at aphelion. When Pluto is close to the sun, far away I go. But when I'm near the sun, I cross Neptune's orbit, you know. Because of our mirrored personalities, Pluto and I also have many similarities. My one moon, Phanth, is very large compared to me. Similar to Pluto and its moon Charon, you see. Phanth is probably a captured Kuiper belt object because it is red in color and I'm not. We're as close together as a planet and moon can be. It only takes Phanth 9.5 days to orbit me. Another similarity to unfurl. We're both named after gods of the underworld. My name, Orcus, is Etruscan, after the underworld's punisher of the condemned. Phanth is the goddess that guides souls to the underworld below, like Charon, the ferryman of dead souls. They call me the Anti-Pluto. You can call me Orcus, though. With some similarities and differences to discuss, let me tell you a little more about us. Astronomers refer to me as a KBO, a Kuiper belt object spotted long ago. Officially discovered in 2004, even though I was photographed decades before. February 17, 2004 is when I was found by Chatroo Hero, David Rabinowitz, and Mike Brown. Later they realized that a sky survey had been done that captured me in pictures back in 1951. Another similarity to Pluto that is opportune: both Pluto and I have a 2-3 resonance with Neptune. For every 3 orbits that Neptune gets, we both get to complete 2 orbits. I take about 245 years to orbit around our sun, very close to Pluto's 248-year duration. Many people wanted my moon to be named Porcus, so we'd be Orcus Porcus when people referred to us. Mike Brown found this amusing but wanted to be more serious, so my moon was named Phanth after the Etruscan goddess. I could have cryovolcanoes on me, that would be nice, which would explain why my surface is covered in water ice. They call me the Anti-Pluto, you can call me Orcus, though. Named after the underworld god that punishes the condemned, from the mythology of the Etruscans. Candidate Orcus and my moon Phanth here, across the solar system from Pluto like a mirror. I'm called the Anti-Pluto because I orbit oppositely. When Pluto's at perihelion, I'm at aphelion, you see. I'm known as the Anti-Pluto. You can call me Orcus, though. In a 2-3 resonance with Neptune, I hope to be made an official dwarf planet soon. I'm Gonggong with my moon Zhang Lu, a dwarf planet candidate whose name was picked by you. Named after the destructive water god in Chinese mythology and the nine-headed serpent minister of the Chinese deity. Discovered by Megan Schwamm, Mike Brown, and David Rabinowitz. On July 17th, 2007, they discovered I exist. Using the Samuel Ocean Telescope to survey the sky at the Palomar Observatory, they saw me pass by. 2007 OR10 was the name they first called me, but astronomers agreed to let the public vote for one of these three. The names were Gonggong, Hong, or Vili. The votes were counted and Gonggong won the majority. I was nicknamed Snow White because of water ice on my surface, but I'm actually red in color, so that name just didn't stick. I'm one of the reddest trans-Neptunian objects, probably because I also have methane on my surface. I'm Gonggong with my moon Zhang Lu, a dwarf planet candidate whose name was picked by you. Named after the destructive water god in Chinese mythology and the nine-headed serpent minister of the Chinese deity. I live way out in the scattered disk, a region partially in the Kuiper belt but stretching far beyond it. Still within the Oort cloud, filled with rocky, icy objects, Neptune scattered these objects around into highly elliptical orbits. I'm in a 3-10 orbital resonance with planet Neptune. For every 3 orbits I complete, Neptune completes 10. We're in tune. Pluto is also in an orbital resonance with Neptune. For every 3 orbits Neptune makes, Pluto makes 2. It takes 554 years until one Gonggong year is done. I have an eccentric elliptical orbit around our sun. 34 AU is my perihelion, and I get as far as 101 AU at aphelion. I'm Gonggong with my moon Zhang Lu, a dwarf planet candidate whose name was picked by you. Named after the destructive water god in Chinese mythology and the nine-headed serpent minister of the Chinese deity. One Gonggong day is similar to one Earth day. I only take about 22 hours to rotate. Compared to other candidates, I have a slow rotation rate, which is probably caused by Zhang Lu and tidal forces he creates. Long ago, I may have had cryovolcanism on me, where water from my interior erupted to my surface, you see. It's possible that I may have a very thin atmosphere, but confirmation of this isn't yet quite clear.
I'm the fifth largest trans-Neptunian object known, approximately the size of Pluto's moon Charon. I'm still considered a dwarf planet candidate, but hope to soon be promoted to an official dwarf planet. I'm Gonggong with my moon Zhang Lu, a dwarf planet candidate whose name was picked by you.